You're back and we're back and you're on PTN, the Pocono Television Network. Thank you so much for watching. Love to have you here. And guess what? It's another beautiful day in the Pocono Mountains. Don't you know that it is? We are in Jim Thorpe. And first of all, I think before we introduce this young lady here, I'd like this quick shout out to the folks at Penn's Peak, Howard Scharf and the rest. Thank you for hosting us. We had a wonderful time. We're gonna be going on the train this afternoon and we are just enjoying our time here. But I'm gonna turn to Marlon first. Marlon is someone we've known for a long time, very supportive of tourism and all things Jim Thorpe and Carbon County. Marlon, great to have you here.
Well, thank you, Chris, and welcome to one of our beautiful gems of the
love
county.
Love.
We love it here, and so much history and, you know, starting off with Mock Chunk. I don't know if people realize, but Mock Chunk was the name of this town, and they realized that they really needed something to draw in visitors and folks. So in the early 1950s, it was named Jim Thorpe, and that was after the Olympian Jim Thorpe, football player. And since then, you know, it's just been an amazing, amazing draw. And we're very blessed to have Jim Thorpe, to have beautiful small shops and great history here. And you've got to come check us out.
And then the other thing, too, I noticed is there's so much natural activity with the river here. Talk a little bit about that. That's amazing.
It is. We are so blessed. I can tell you this. I love it here. I work here. I live here. I play here. And it's because of the river, the mountains, everything that you can do outdoors. And you don't have to be an extreme outdoorist. If you want to come and just what I call, you need some blue sky time. You want to get out. You want to enjoy the mountains. You want to enjoy the river so you can bike and kayak and hike and then take a walk downtown and try the little shops and then grab a great bite to eat. You can really do it all here.
And you can find really unique items in these shops you really can't find anywhere else.
Exactly. And what I like to say, Chris, is our small shop owners have really big hearts and they provide the most unique items that when you walk away from a weekend or a week here, you're going to remember this place because you're going to have something for yourself or maybe for somebody else. And it really is, we're just blessed.
And we didn't even talk about the mansion, right?
Right, right.
Asa Packer Mansion, what an amazing property.
Yes, both mansions, again, a lot of history there, and the founder of Lehigh University built those, and we've got the Asa Packer Mansion, and that's open for tours. And then the Harry Packer Mansion is actually a murder mystery weekend that you can come in and enjoy the weekend and enjoy the beautiful architecture and have a glass of wine out on the porch. Just lovely.
So then the architecture of the town too, those mansions are an example of that.
They really are. Again, we have visitors that come honestly just to walk down the street, go to the mansions because of the architecture. It's beautiful. When you look up and you see history, it's just a great feeling. And again, you can do anything here, whether you love history or architecture or the outdoors.
And we happen to have a visitor center here right in the center of Jim Thorpe, and those folks will help you to plan any activity here. But you can also check out PoconoMountains.com. There's an interactive map on PoconoMountains.com that can get you not only to Jim Thorpe, but all the other related activities throughout the Pocono Mountains. So, Marlon, just one more question. If a guest came up to any of us and said, there's one or two things you have to do while you're here in Jim Thorpe, what would that be?
Well, number one, you've got to take a train ride. There's no question. That takes you any time of year that you can see the beautiful, beautiful outdoors. And I would say definitely visit downtown. You know, again, the streets that we have here are beautiful. They're quaint. It's been rebuilt. The shop owners are delightful. And you're going to get a great bite to eat. So,
And you're really seeing the real people that operate those shops.
Absolutely.
And operate the restaurants. It's not that they're bad, but not a big corporation.
Right.
It's you get that real feeling of a one-on-one experience with the proprietor. I'm lying, so one more thing. How about number nine, mine? I got to shout that out while we're here. So,
you know, again, that's one of those little hidden gems. So when you're in downtown Jim Thorpe, it's not that far away. So you get to see right there history, number nine mine, the coal mines, what folks had to do so many years ago. And it really opens your eyes to that. So I love it. You've got to come and see it.
Well, good. Marlon's giving you some of the gems that are right here in Jim Thorpe in the Pocono Mountains. And we again want to thank you and remind you, you're watching PTN, the Pocono Television Network. I'm Chris Barrett. Thanks for watching.